Yeah. So it is my pleasure to share my experience before this gathering. We don't claim to be very successful, okay, in executing this project. But definitely there has been some degree of success. There has been some failures also. But I think at the end of it, definitely we have gained from it. And we know exactly where we have gone wrong, wherever we have failed. And that's a learning for the future. Now, coming to this shipbuilding project, see, this shipyard is located, I mean, we took a decision sometime in 2007 to set up a shipyard among the various sites which we discussed, I mean, we went through. Finally, we decided Kattupalli, which is north of Chennai. As many of you know, that north of Chennai is not the best of places to be because it is not developed. The infrastructure is not developed. So in maybe in now, the of course, the things are changing. There's an improvement in infrastructure. And maybe in next 5 years, it will be quite a developed place. So, but being the first to, I mean, there are, of course, other, we are the only private sector. There are other in the government sector, thermal power stations, which are there. And of course, the Ennore port is also there. So this, just come. Yeah. So as I said that we set up a mega shipyard at Kattupalli near Ennore. The facility would undertake building of defense and commercial vessels and also undertake repairs. Project got the approval in December 2008. And the execution team, of course, we decided that we have to do in the shortest possible time because there was a large investment which we were making in this, and that's why we had to do it in the shortest possible time. It was a daunting task considering that we had to set up the marine facilities. Now, when we went there, the we were open, the seas opened, you know, it's to the Bay of Bengal, and seas very at times very rough. And setting up any marine facility has its own problem because many times your work is interrupted because of bad weather. And as we saw later on, that there were three cyclones also which we had to face, where the work had come to a stop and there was some amount of damage also. And, but based on our, we had actually, this is not the first experience for us in implementing this critical chain. We have actually done many years back and we are still doing it in the heavy engineering this group. And that's why, because of our conviction that this is a good way to manage a project, we decided to use this methodology. And we chose Realization Technologies to be our partners in implementation. Just, I mean, for those who do not know, this the bottom is the airport, and the top is where the shipbuilding is. The distance, it's a total distance of almost 55 kilometers. The project comprised of 19 production shops, along with equipment installation as well as the crane installation. There are associated services like power, roads inside the complex, sewage, freshwater, firefighting system. There was breakwater construction, breakwaters to be constructed almost 3.5 kilometers deep into the sea. This would give the protection to the shipyard as well as the port, which is coming up there. A shiplift of size 46 meters by 200 meters. This is, mind you, quite a large size, 46 by 200. The largest, this which I know, which exists, is about 275 meters long shiplift in the world. And our shiplift is designed for 260 meters. But at the moment, we have gone, it's a modular construction, and we have gone for only 200 meters. It can anytime be extended further. Lifting capacity, having a lifting capacity of almost 18,500, it can lift a ship out of water, weighing almost 18,500 tons. This is the second ship lift in India, which was built. The first being 175 by 25 meters long, it's very small compared to what we are doing. It is totally, as Kapil said, that it is totally designed and built by L&T. The breakwaters, you can see the two breakwaters almost 1.7 kilometers long each. And you can see the ship lift in the center. I will come to the detail later. We had over almost 1,900 crores investment in this facility. And the cost to us would be, by the way of, would be almost 1 crore per day by the way of interest and depreciation. Hence, timely completion of the shipyard would enable to, I mean, that was recover, to start the revenues as well as to bid for large orders. Only when the shipyard is ready, we would get approval and be able to bid for large projects. Shiplift in particular, it's a common facility between to do a repair, either you have to have a dry dock where you can dock the ships, or you have to shiplift where you can lift the ship out of water and take it to the dry berth. So this facility, and for from the new build, it was necessary to have this facility to launch a ship into water. And we were between the two projects. I'll come to the next project, which was the shops and the associated facilities. But the ship lift was more important for us. First is because it would take a longer time to do build it. And secondly, we could, the ship is going through a downturn, shipbuilding is going to a downturn, whereas the repair business is a good the business, and we could start soon on that. This is a photograph of a completed ship lift. As you can see, it's a platform. I mean, I'll just show you a small movie so that you'll understand what it is. The hoists, which each hoist is 600 tons. There are about 80 hoists which lift the platform out of water. You can see that the ship has come and now the platform is rising. The platform has come up to the level of the ground. This is a ship transfer system, which is a set of trolleys moving under the ship. It has a hydraulic jack, so it will lift. The ship is resting on trestles, and the ship is getting lifted. And the whole load is coming on the trolley. And now it is moving out of the platform. So it is coming to a cross transfer area because the berth is on the other side, so it has to move sideways. So now the ship is again resting on the ground, the trolleys are free of the ground. The trolleys rotate by 90 degrees. So now the it moves sideways and then onto a dry berth for repair. So the entire this when I say the ship lift project, it consisted of not only the platform, the civil work, this is building the jetties, the hoists, the ship transfer system, and the other berths also. Now the initially when we planned the ship lift, we had started October 2009, and we planned to complete it by March 2011. Okay, almost 18 months for this. Later on, somewhere during the year, I mean, during the execution of the project, we decided that the ship, earlier it was 150 meters long, we decided that it should be 200 because we saw the business, shiplift repair business, and we felt that, and also the new build business, and we felt that we should build a ship of two, I mean, a ship lift of 200 meters long so we can cater to bigger ships. As I said, it is a modular construction. We could have even increased it to 260 meters. So the project scope was revised and the completion was planned as September 2011. Now, these are the problems that we faced. During the course of manufacture, we had three cyclones, which you may be knowing. We had, you know, this sand getting, this is always for construction, is always a problem, which, and there was a ban on river sand. So we had to set up a plant to make the sand, okay, generate, I mean, crush the stone and prepare this. Heavy manpower shortage at that part of Chennai, it's difficult to get a manpower because the conditions, it is far from the city, and as far as accommodation is concerned, it's really a problem. So manpower getting there was also a problem. Plus there are other projects in the country where the people used to, I mean, after coming here, they used to find better places to work and they used to go there. 5 months, we had a setback because the plates, which you are, the platform is weighing 8,000 tons. We had ordered plates for the platform and the ship got, the owner went bankrupt. The ship was stuck somewhere near Greece. And then finally, we had to, after a lot of delay, we could somehow get the plate. So it resulted in a delay of almost 5 months for starting the fabrication of platform. And what outs? We gave order to a Korean company. He supplied, since I said that the project scope was revised, initial order we gave was a large one. He did it in time. We assumed that he will do the remaining, the extended part also in time, but he delayed thereafter. It was a big setback for us. So 4 months we lost in that. And of course, for civil work, there's a piling to be done. We found that while driving the piles or while boring the piles, we found there was a hard soil at a depth of 30. The shiplift piles, were incidentally, were 50 meters long. So we could, much of it we could, you know, by proper planning and recovery, we could manage. But there are certain things which we could not recover. Okay, there was 4 months of this and five, almost 9 months of this, which we found it difficult to recover, but still, by what my colleague, Mr. Pranay Patak, will explain, that out 5 months we could recover, and ultimately we ended up delaying by about 4 months. So January 2012, we could and get the ship lift tested and certified. Now, we found at the beginning, we realized that such a project cannot get completed in time unless there is a team which is formed, dedicated team for this project management. And there was at a senior most level, there was a heavy engineering president and also a member of the board. He was overseeing the project every 15 days, right from the start of the project till the commissioning. Every fortnight, he was reviewing the project. Then there was a key management team which was there, which every week we had a review. Of course, daily we were saying, but there was a formal review every week to see what actions, to see where we are delayed, what actions need to be taken, and whether the resource, how the resources are to be mobilized. Then there was a real, from the realization side, there was a director who was overseeing that. And we had, of course, many other people who were involved with the during the execution of the project. Here, I would like to tell you that implementing this critical chain, we not only had to do, but the people, our major contractor, which was our construction group, they have never done it in the using this methodology. Okay, but it was, I mean, we could convince them to use it for our project here. And they actively participated in it. When you are reviewing this, you have to update, you know, tasks. You have to go through the schedule. You have to update the tasks. And you have to see. So all these people who are involved with the project, used the system, cooperated, and saw that we could effectively use this CCPM for project management. Then, of course, project teams were there. And the team, we did planning, ensure that the critical chain rules were followed. I will also tell you that somewhere we didn't follow the rules and we didn't get the results as expected. full kit. Another thing, what Mr. Venkatramanan said is that you have to have everything ready. You know, you can't start, you have something and you start, and then you have something else, you start another thing. That way you cannot do a successful project. You have to have a full kit. You define what are the things necessary before start of the work, and then you should start the work. So the defining the full kit in the beginning and ensuring that it happens is very important to the success of the project. Alignment of the contractors. Contractors often tend to do the way what is beneficial to them. So they have to be aligned with your thinking, and you have to go over the plans along with them, whatever your thought. Then only you can get the results. Enforce resource allocation. Again, resources is a very important consideration. Unless the resource is used in a proper way, you will be wasting the resource. Driving task preparation on the ground. Okay, people sometimes, I mean, you are, before you start a task, you have to think over how you are going to do that. And unless you have done the preparation, you will not do the task in time. Reviews, project delays happen, delay happens, so many uncertainties are there, delays happen. But you have to see what are you going to do about it. How are you going to, are, is it possible to recover the delay? If not, then what are you going to do about it? Are you going to add resources? Look after for upcoming, you know, you have to foresee some problems. You can, when you review it, you can see that some problems are coming. Okay, for shiplift, you know, we face so many problems. Of course, I can spend a lot of time explaining that, but we don't have that much time. But you have to foresee that and see what actions you need to take. Identify process improvements. You have to look for, if you have a constraint, then are you going to live with that constraint, or are you going to see that your constraint is overcome some way? So you have to think of what process improvements you can do. Now I will request my colleague Pranay Patak to take it further.
Good evening, everyone. I'll be further discussing some of the key critical success factors that we achieved in the particularly in this shiplift project. What has been covered so far is for the entire shipyard. The implementation that was done with the help of realization team at site, how certain problems that we had faced, how that were, they were overcome, and how the result which has already been discussed with you, the 9 months of delay that was contained within 4 months, which could have been 9 months or probably more longer because of the various problems that we have faced all along the path. So I'll be rushing through some of the key critical success factors. From the beginning itself, when the realization team stepped into the execution, or before the execution, there was a phase when we were planning the activities of how the entire project will be executed. There was a plan, a broad plan for the shiplift alone that was chalked up. And this is how it looked like initially. We had a civil works, a long chain of civil works, which was running across the entire, almost the entire length of the project. Then we had a parallel chain of platform fabrication, the same 8,000 tons of steel that had to be fabricated in a given period of roughly 8 to 9 months, and that too on site against monsoons and cyclones. And then there was hoist manufacturing, which was happening at a different location in Mumbai, our L&T Powai factory, and the transfer system chains. Now, what you also see in this plan is there are a lot of activities which are happening parallel as well as which are interlinked. Which are happening in parallel as well as which are interlinked. What you see here is a typical case of a project where civil works, mechanical works, electrical works, and some other components come together, get integrated, have to be tested, commissioned, and then put to use. The arrows which you see are basically the interlinks or interfaces at each stage, like the 200 meters of shiplift that we are talking of had close to 450 piles. There was at each stage some length of the jetty was supposed to be completed and handed over to the platform fabrication team for erecting the platform. The platform, entire platform of 200 meters is modular and made up of 16 modules. So each module has to be erected, and then the subsequent or corresponding hoists have to be erected. Now what we see here is a lot of multitasking, not at the resource level, because being in a project environment, it is always assumed at the planning stage that whatever resource we require will be available, but at the management level. When realization came in and when we had the first round of discussions we had, what came out as a plan is this, what you see in front of you. With a revised plan and almost the same timelines, we were trying to achieve three main factors. One factor which was very core to the whole concept of executing was de-risking, what we call as risk mitigation. The purpose of doing that was, as rightly has been told by Kapil as well as Mr. Prabhu, is that this project L&T was executing for the first time. In India and in the world, there are not many companies who dare to come up with projects like Shiplift, because it's a monopoly, almost a monopoly held by Rolls-Royce. We were not sure of what all technical challenges we'll come across. There was a fear that if there is a technical hitch which comes towards the right side of the project, there is a possibility that the delays may be very large and catching up or closing them will be more difficult. So one aim that we always wanted was de-risking at a much earlier stage. And what we see here is the full kit for commissioning. We were trying to pull in the date of integrated commissioning much earlier than which was planned. Which was planned at much later date in the previous project. The other thing that we tried to achieve was WIP reduction. Now, WIP reduction, again, at this point, it was not regarding only the resource, but as has been pointed out by Mr. Venkatraman and Kapil also, was at the management level. The plan which you see at the top had lot of chains running in parallel and would have required lot of intervention of management at each level for each chain versus the plan which you see at the bottom. And the third and the most critical thing that we tried to achieve was create buffers. Each chain, each contractor left to his own would like to complete the project in his own rightful duration. But what we told everyone that was involved with this project was that every stakeholder has to give up his buffer. He has to contribute to the project buffer as well as the feeding buffer for the chains. There is one more small thing which is a point which probably Realization discusses in their technical meeting. The one thing that we have also tried to achieve in this plan is what we want to be on the we wanted to be on the critical path. We can either let the plan decide as to which resource or which particular chain will be part of the critical chain, or we can plan it accordingly in such a way that we can say that, okay, which all the activities are important, which resources are important, and accordingly we will elevate them and we will plan in such a way that always they are the ones which are on the critical path and being monitored continuously, rather than other chains which are much more in control, like the hoist manufacturing and the transfer system which were happening in Mumbai, in Powai, in a shop environment, in a much controlled way. We had some problems some delays in those chains also, but they were recovered with due monitoring, proper monitoring. I now move on to the next critical success factor. This is primarily a case of a typical case which probably anyone, not just in infrastructure project related environment, would face, but even someone who is involved in manufacturing or in any kind of repetitive activity which one comes across, this kind of implementation is very much possible. So as part of the 8,000 tons of platform fabrication, the smaller components that get fabricated initially have to finally be put together and assembled. So what you see here is a batch of four modules, the total 16 modules which comprised of 200 meters of the ship lift. We decided that of all the 16 modules, we'll be assembling four at a time and then launching them further. And this was the overall plan chalked based upon the space availability and the resource availability. The plan, in due consideration and commitment from the contractor, we had said that one batch will take 43 days. And the resource requirement projected, the main resource, which was the welders projected, was 130 numbers. But the contractor could mobilize only 75 to 85 welders. What we ended up in the first batch itself was a 27-day delay. Now, there are two things to look at this picture. Right now, what we see is a 27 days delay. How, through the concerto monitoring and the weekly buffer recovery meetings that we were monitoring, how that helped at that early stage of the project was that we can either look at the entire chain with only a 27-day delay and the contractor promising that he will catch up in the subsequent chains, or we look at this picture. being unable to continuously mobilize more welders, there is a possibility that the chains, subsequent chains also are going to come up with the same amount of additional time consumption. And we are looking at 100 plus days of delay. At this point of time, with the help of the management, a decision was taken, which is an implementation factor which realization proposes a lot, is WIP reduction, work in progress. So what we basically did was we froze down, actually literally froze down the assembly of modules from 4 to 3. And all subsequent modules, the batches were reduced to 3. And these are the times which you see. The last batch was completed in 27 days. The overall delay which we had projected of 100 plus, out of that we could recover 70 days of delay. Next, moving on, this is basically a pictorial representation of how the batch of 3 modules we had done. So the space constraint is basically, there was the actual space available for continuous production was the consideration why we had started with batch of 4. But subsequently, based upon the available resource availability, we had to reduce it down to 3 batches. Moving on to the third factor, this particularly we are going to discuss here the risk mitigation and the replanning activity that we do normally through the course of the project. We had an initial plan where the activities were supposed to happen in series. There was a platform erection stage where the entire 200 meters of platform was supposed to be erected in one go. Then there was a hoist erection stage where 68 hoists had to be erected. And then there was a long chain of 2 months of ship lift commissioning where load test was to be done, some setting to cold settings, hot settings had to be done, and then final third-party inspection and commissioning had to be done. As we moved along the project, we realized that there were certain delays. There were delays in the civil works, there were delays in the arrival of the plate, because of which the dates were getting pushed, the buffer was getting consumed. And so to absorb these delays, we came up with a plan where the module, the platform erection and the hoist erection chains were made parallel to an extent such that technically we were achieving the results what was there in the above chain. There was a de-risking also made part of this same chain, whereby we were able to pull in the part of the ship lift commissioning, which was basically the first integrated testing. We were able to pull in with the first module that was erected and the first 6 hoists along with which it was erected. We were able to test it. So we were able to establish that the system does work. And subsequent modules could be launched in a similar manner, subsequent hoists could be erected in the similar manner. What did happen midway was the scope increase of 50 meters that involved reordering of some of the components. One of the Korean supplier could not supply the components on time. There was a delay. And we came across, we were standing at a situation where we had gone ahead and done erection and installation up to 13 modules, and we were waiting for that one component to arrive, which was in, if you see the entire project of ship lift, that one component is not huge, it's actually peanuts, but it held the entire balance chain of the project. So what we did at that point of time was replanning in such a way that the ship lift commissioning activity was broken into 2 parts. The load testing was pulled in. It was actually done before the entire platform was erected. This particular picture would make it much clearer. You see only two-thirds of the platform actually erected and going towards water below the yard level. And this is the portion that we tested and established the entire system. We actually completed the load testing in presence of Lloyd's register. And we took them also in confidence, making sure that the balance activity which is left at the end is much smaller. Once the components arrive, we can quickly launch the other modules and we can further, only a small activity of ship lift commissioning would be left. What is also important here in this particular implementation was a full kitting. Throughout the chain, throughout these events of replanning and de-risking, what we continuously did was have a team meeting on continuous basis, which was always focused on establishing full kits and making sure that much before the task is completed, the full kits are complete. And as we moved along, for each type of uncertainty that we envisaged that could come across, we always try to come up with a backup plan. We always try to come up with a backup plan. So the key learning here was implementation of a proper full kit, where all the uncertainties, where all the inputs required for achieving a particular milestone were decided and were achieved, were committed by each of the stakeholders. And once execution started, whatever replanning was required for any uncertainty, delay, there was always a fallback option. There was always a replan that was available, alternate plan that was available. This is the test rig, incidentally, that was used for load testing. You can see how the entire load of 3,500 tons was created just to move it along the platform to test it. We now come to a critical success factor which was encountered much earlier in the project. It was related to the civil works. It had the impact on civil works was from the marine front as well as from the environment, from the weather front. And this is particularly a delay that we encountered due to coming across a hard soil strata across roughly around 30 meters while we were digging the piles. Now, throughout this implementation, what we are trying to achieve is that what we are trying to depict here is that there was a cycle time, a planned cycle time of 5 days against which we could only establish with all the resources, which could establish a cycle time of 10 days. With additional resources also, with additional resources also, that 12 days could be brought down only to 10 days. At this point of time, we took a decision that there is a possibility, there are a lot of slacks within this cycle of 10 days also, and there is a possibility of reducing these 10 days by conducting a study and removing the waste time that might be there within these 10 days. A work motion study was conducted with the help of realization. And based upon the results and recommendations, the management directed the team, the contractor and the team, to implement certain changes in the methodology in which they were executing. Thereby, we were able to reduce the cycle time entirely from 10 days to 7 days. So what you see here is a reduction is achieved, a bigger reduction in the cycle time we were able to achieve, not by additional resources, but by actually conducting a proper time study and implementing it. One of the main factors was that the contractor buy-in was there. He actually agreed and implemented whatever recommendations were given based upon the time motion study conducted. This is the situation that is there. The piles that were to be driven, because of the delay, lot of changes were done on the way the piling was done. The new resources, even after bringing in of new resources, the piling time was not being reduced. Based upon the time motion study, a lot of changes were made how work was being done. And using of this particular equipment, which we call a jack-up, this was also optimized. And more than the work that it was envisaged to do initially, we made sure and optimized the use of this jack-up to the extent that every third day, this jack-up was being lowered into the water and shifted between these two piers to ensure that none of the other resources were being idle. Moving on to the next and the last critical success factor. This is a pretty daring success factor, I would say. I'd just move on to the next slide first. See, this is the entire, in a picture, if we were to describe the 8,000 tons of fabrication, this is how the fabrication proceeded. The plates have been stored, there were components in a batch manner, they were being produced here. And in a cycle, after blasting painting, they were moved into the module area where the final module assembly was taking place. The entire span of this particular fabrication itself was pretty long, close to 8 to 9 months. Now, midway, when the module assembly work started, we realized that the contractor is not able to come up with enough resource, which is also something which we have discussed in one of the earlier factors. However, on the other hand, since this process was streamlined already, and we were pretty comfortable in the execution that had been achieved in the pre-component area. So there was a decision that was taken if we had continued to let the entire project execute in the manner such that these components continued to get manufactured, but there was a delay in these assembly of these modules, the final shiplift assembly would not have got completed. And that is what was on the critical chain. So to ensure that the critical activities which are on critical chain are the ones that are getting completed, are the ones that are given higher priority, are the ones for which all the resources are subordinated, a decision was taken to move welders from here over to this activity. It is a in a normal project environment, we would call it counterintuitive, that you're shifting manpower, you're shifting resource from an activity which is very much in control to an activity which is already delayed, and trying to control that by shifting resources from an activity which is already very much in control. But if you see the results, what we had projected, the delays that were there initially, we were able to, throughout the balance period of fabrication, we were able to maintain them within the maximum time that we had projected, the delays that we had projected earlier on. This is the overall shiplift project across how it has moved along. There are certain portions, the implementations which we have already discussed, what all problems we had faced. So I'll not spend much time on this slide. I'll next come to the another project, similar project in the same facility that we had executed. The shiplift was on the waterfront. Along with the shiplift, a shipyard requires shops to do the production. Now, what you see in this particular slide is the shops, the shipyard as it looks now, along with all the services that we have already discussed. The shops infrastructure, basically, that project involved execution of 19 production shops, which was basically the PB, the civil works, the PB structure, and all the equipment that was supposed to be coming inside the shops. Along with that, the associated services of roads, drainage, firefighting lines, cabling, freshwater, and sewerage. We did manage to achieve, we did manage to complete the entire project, but there were certain milestones that we had kept for ourselves, internal milestones. There were three phases in which all 19 shops were broken down, and they were supposed to be completed against each of those milestones. What we are trying to share is that implementation was not that successful. Why it was not very successful? Particularly, two major reasons were that the full kit, we somehow feel now when we look back at the project, we somehow feel that the full kit was not fully implemented, the full kit was not fully made ready, and at a much earlier stage, the work front was released, the execution go-ahead was given, which actually cascaded down everything, and what we ended up was that time required for vendor, since there were so many activities that were supposed to happen, roads, drainage, firefighting, cabling, PB of the shops and all, everything that was supposed to happen in parallel. What we could not do because of a partially achieved full kit was that the level of coordination and sync required between the contractors and the people who are executing the management, that could not be achieved right at the beginning of the project. And this continued to cascade along, this continued in the form of firefighting and multitasking and frequent change of priorities. Between the two projects, the shiplift, where the implementation of TOC concept, we did achieve some results. We were able to contain a lot of delays as well as retain or pull in certain delays. Compared to the shops and infrastructure project, where under the same, in the same facility and under the same management, the results were not that good. First and the most striking reason comes out is that the full kit basically was released at 50% preparation under due date pressure. And now when we look back, we realize that had proper preparedness been given, had the full kit been made ready, there would have been delay. We are not saying that by making or spending time on full kit, we would not have come across delay, but the delays would not have been as long as they were. In the shiplift project, in the first factor which we shared, in which the plan was reduced to a lesser WIP from the management point of view. Throughout the course of the execution, what we realized was that since there were lesser chains to monitor, there were lesser decisions being taken up to the management, and there were lesser focus points for the management. On the same time, for the shops side, since a lot of activities were happening, there was always a firefighting and a lot of tasks were in the red, had to be executed. Everything was being taken up to the management, and there were much more focus dispersion in the shop side. Similarly, the escalated tasks or the emergent issues or any delays, uncertainties that were coming up in the shiplift project, the management was able to focus much more in that side rather than on the shop side. The full kit and the planning that we were able to complete in the beginning of the project, that also enabled us or helped us with the low WIP plan, it also helped us to continuously carry on that concept of conducting meetings, conducting full kit meetings, ensuring that everyone has a buy-in, ensuring that people do accept the fact that full kits have to be completed, and see the benefit of that full kit completion coming out in the results that were being achieved, which have also been shared here, versus the other side where actually instead of trying to complete the full kits, we were at a situation where the inputs itself were coming through during the execution or through the execution period. This is similar reasoning as above. The next slide is basically the key learnings from the entire implementation that was done for the shipyard. I'd now request Mr. Prabhu to just summarize them.
Sorry, we have taken more time than what we were given. Yeah. So the first learning is that there has to be a top management commitment, okay, to the whatever solutions that we have worked out. Now, here we had thought of using this CCPM for implementation. So all of us were very convinced that this is the right way to manage the project. And that was very important because it sent messages down the line. So if people came out with something, we had to convince them why it is, how it can be overcome. Even when resources are inadequate, delays can still be controlled. Okay, because as you have seen in the case of when we had less number of elders, by reducing the WIP and making the project go faster, we could still control the progress. Full kit, I will not talk because he has already talked about that, full kit, importance of full kit. Contractor alignment, we had seen the difference in the initial phase for the shops and the later phase, alignment of the contractors with whatever you are deciding, the way you want to go about, he has to be in agreement or he has to be convinced if he is not in agreement. Discipline in task updation. Now, where we many times fail is that people are not disciplined to update the task. Okay, and that when you review the project, it doesn't give a correct picture. So that is, and lastly, it is innovation. Whenever you're faced with a problem and you want to recover buffer, you have to come and think, okay, think, I mean, let people at all level think about it and how to find a solution. And as we seen during the various, we came out with certain solutions which reduced the delay to a large extent. So this is in a summary of what we have presented. I'm sure there'll be some questions, but I would request, since we are already taken up more time, probably we can discuss it over dinner.